Note, this is a joke of creepypasta that I made for fun XD. Also, if you're expecting your normal Lost episode creepypasta, then, well, prepare to be disappointed about this. Dash 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 dash. TBH, I didn't really watch Eek the Cat before this movie, so I wasn't a fan. I really just had the intro to watch, as my flea markets and thrift stores I usually go to don't have any VHS tapes, nor any other form of media for the show itself, but with the exception of that terrible SNES game. The only footage I could find around the late 90s on the internet was a video of the intro, though since it was the 90s, it was in poor quality, which some may consider nostalgic. However, though, something quite made my eye rather wowed by this factor. It was a purple box with a note on top that said in a green marker, "You must watch," which was quite something unexpected for its life. Maybe the movie was going to be an amazing film everyone would watch. I asked the person near the box that had a name of Kevin Wesson. Kevin Wesson said, "I don't have any clue where it came from, as I just found it at night somehow moving on its own, so take it for free nonetheless, and anyway." I replied, "Huh, weird. Well, thank you for such an offer from a flea market that's only 14 blocks away from me." After that, he replied back with, "You're welcome." After my regular shopping at the almost nearby flea market, I went back to my house, started getting out some buttered popcorn, and after 5 minutes I was ready to watch what's inside the box. Once I opened it, however, I heard a weird but suddenly understandable voice. The voice was, "Phew, thanks for getting me out of that dumb box I put myself in. Now, put the tape in your VCR ASAP. ! I quickly found out it was a purple cat, and I asked, "Hey, are you Eek the Cat from the cartoon, and why do you want me to put it in quickly?" The cat replied with, "I'm Eek the Cat, and there's no time to explain now. I wanna get back to the cartoon world of the city, which I can't remember its name. Also, I don't wanna miss my girlfriend, and I'm gonna have to defeat a new character, so put in the tape right now. Going to be a regular movie really, but it's very strange to see that I have to get a character back into his cartoon world, which made me question what's with the tape. Is the tape the way to put him back in the cartoon world he supposedly lives in?" I quickly and swiftly put in the tape, and oh boy, was it a wild ride. It didn't really start in the intro, but instead some stone text appeared saying, "Eek the Cat's movie," which could suggest that this is a movie based off the cartoon. Also, Eek the Cat appeared nowhere in it, which is also rather strange, but I did expect that, as Eek wants to be back into it. Instead, a strange orange cat with a blue shirt appeared out of the cloud saying, "Well folks, Bernard the Cat is here, and I'm gonna wreck in the havoc." And he sounded like one of those kids that tried to be cool and radical. He was running through buildings, houses, and other regular stuff you'd see in town, and got to that strange shark dog that I didn't know was in the show, but then again, I didn't watch the show before this, so don't judge me. The shark dog tried to outrun him, but he wasn't able to, as Bertner outrun him instead. Bertner reached into the shark dog's mouth and grabbed a strange blue light ball, but there was absolutely no blood, nor gore for that matter. Instead, the shark dog straight up froze into cyan diamonds. He kept running to the right for about 15 seconds, which made me get bored, but he made it to a portal. However, though, it wasn't your regular portal, as it was able to talk, and you have to put in a ball on the right of the portal in order to travel to the real world. The portal suddenly grew eyes and said this in a voice that sounded half robotic, half manly. I see you have a soul, and I hope you have Sharky's soul." That weird portal later told Birdner to put that soul onto the right of it, and it scanned the soul. "Yes, this is the one I was hoping you'll bring. Now get to the real world and stop Eek from his very existence. M-U-H-A-H-A-H-A-H-A-H-A-A-A-A-A. Exclamation. The portal said. I was shocked to see how that would be really in the movie. This alone made me ask Eek, why is that happening? Eek replied with, I was pushed out by my girlfriend who said, this'll make you safe, and I fell down there very fast like a bullet. Suddenly, I appeared near that guy at the flea market. I won't get to all the details though, so don't take it too far. Which made me think that Birdner is overpowered, but I was later turned out to be wrong. Once Birdner arrived at my house, he shouted out, alright Eek, it's no longer gonna be any more of you. I was a little scared, but Eek pulled out of the box a sword which I honestly didn't know was in there on, and it made Birdner take out his sword out of the pockets on the back of his shirt, strangely enough. Then afterwards, a sword fight had begun. They were fighting through my living room to my kitchen, and finally back to the living room, which had Eek poke Birdner on the chest, and Birdner eventually turned into little balls flowing away, and Sharky's soul from the portal flew away from it, reaching Sharky in his frozen diamond form. Sharky's soul was moving into his mouth, and a few seconds later, Sharky became his unfrozen self and said something in the growling language, A.K. He growls instead of speaks, even though Eek strangely understands what he's saying. Thankfully, there were subtitles to help me along which said, congratulations Eek. You defeated Birdner from beating you. Now I must get you back home to the cartoon world somehow. Eek said, I'd say you'd scan yourself. Afterwards, he did, and led Eek back into the cartoon world, making him look very cartoony, of course, which led him to say, thank you for helping me in such an adventure, and you can say, it never hurts to help. Suddenly, it jumped to a black screen saying, thank you for watching and helping with it. Now, go send this tape to the owners of the Eek. The Cat series, as well as this unfinished movie that'll be back in the works. After 2 days, I was finally able to find where they were, and they finished their movie in about 8.5 months. A copy of it came to my door from one of the makers of the movie, and man, did I enjoy it. Now, after that, it really made me want to watch the series, and thankfully I was able to find a lot of home recordings of it at a stock market just 3 miles away from me. Now, I'm glad that I've done that, and it really made me glad to know about the series. Also, if you wanna watch the movie, the series, or heck, even both, do it then. You may enjoy it too.